This is the Squamish and Lillooet Cultural Center. So this facility is set on 5 acres of land. It will be one of the centerpieces to exhibit Aboriginal culture during the 2010 Winter Olympics. This is where we are up here, right? So that guy graduated Corps up there, Corps training. And we're doing 70, we're tracking and training 70 carpenters. This is the Grand Hall, the Grand Exhibit Hall for the Lillooet Squamish Cultural Center. So this hall will be the main feature of the new cultural center. They'll be able to bring exhibits from all over the world back to here, but it's also one of the centerpieces for the 2010 Winter Olympics, okay? 18 of the 24 venues for the Olympics are going to be on either Squamish or Lillooet territory, and this will be a centerpiece for the Olympics. The construction industry wants to partner with Van Asap because they need a lot of these workers, and one of the things they don't need is that they don't need wage subsidies. They don't need our subsidies to hire people. What they do need are our people. I mean, we're in a 4% labor market, and they're bringing people in from all over the world, and we're actually competing with those people. Now, I like this project because we're not competing. The band owns it. And all the people working on this site, Aboriginal. Because we actually have to staff 4 more of these batch plants. So we're going to be involved in the training and staffing of over the next 2 years.
Okay, my name is Jay Mearns. I'm the job coach with Van Asap Training Society. Today you saw the graduation of the participants for the Workplace Safety Officer program put on by Van Asap Training Society in partnership with Vancouver Regional Construction Association and STISMA Training Society. We at Van Asap are very proud of the students who participated in this most recent Workplace Safety Officer program. They came from various aspects of the industry. Some were already junior safety officers, first aid people that their companies wanted them to upskill to full-fledged safety officers. We also have people that are from various other areas of the industry, commercial, industrial, and some were working for subcontractors that required safety officers for some of the projects in Vancouver.
And then just recently I graduated from a CSO program, which was 6 weeks long and extremely intensive, but very informative. It was a hard course. It's a university level course. But, you know, like I had a lot of support from the Métis people and Van Asap and to helping me get all of it done. And I worked really hard and I ended up graduating one of the top of the class.
Thank you, sir.
So I really enjoyed myself. It wasn't easy, but, you know, with a little bit of hard work, I did it and I enjoyed it.
We're very proud of them all. The success rate was outstanding. We had 95% success rate. We're all very proud of them. We expect them all to go out and continue to create a good name for themselves and Van Asap Training Society and foster relationships for other CSOs that might want to participate in this type of training.
We are a construction company that oversees several projects in the Lower Mainland. We have been in business for several years and we preach safety and dedication to leadership in the industry. As I mentioned earlier, we have had a chance to hire some students from the course, and some of them have been with us for over 2 or 3 years now, and it seems to work very well, and we are very proud to assist them. We have a chance to be introduced to their labor force, carpenters, iron workers, and the new program, the CSO program, First Aid, and we have a chance to, like I said, to hire them in the past, and we have already some employees working for us. And the program is very, very successful in a way of knowledge and expertise, and we are very pleased to work with them, and we look forward to do more work together.
I never knew anything about framing like this, and learned about lots about framing and roofs and trusses. And I'd recommend other people to come here because we got good teachers, good environment, got all the tools we need, everything. Good projects like this one. Get to go outside and actually build stuff. It's great, learning a lot. good teacher, good group of guys. They need tradespeople out in the world. Our Red Seal program in BC here, they say, is the best, one of the most recognized one in the world. I love this stuff. I gotta do it. You're always working with your hands, working outside, working with different people, different environments, different places. It's a very good program. Learn lots. Like, Dick is a very good instructor. You get lots from this course. Main thing is math. Math will be your best friend your whole life. You will learn and learn until you're old, man. I find this course pretty easy. I'm fortunate because I really like math in school. I see myself with my Red Seal. I'll make my own construction business once I have about 5 years experience with Red Seal. And I'll be teaching other people how to be apprenticed and like teaching them how to do their own construction, make their own buildings instead of hiring the outside people to come and do it. You'll have to know it yourself. They've been so good to me, the Métis. Ever since I got here, it's nothing but good to me. But it's all about state of mind, determination, and persistence too. It's just, it feels a little homey when you come to school. That's how it should be. Stay in school, always. School will make you be successful.